Welcome all. We have already started our second lesson, that was motion of earth. I hope you have seen our first video. I have also given an animated video for you which was there after the main video which I have taught. If you have seen it, the earlier part which I have taught you will be more easy to understand. We have seen the leap year. We have seen how that one day is added in the leap year, which is adjusted in February month. Now we will proceed further. Before that, we will just see what has been given in this green color box. So, do you know? You know that the length of the day and night is not always equal. Yes, if you have observed that sometimes the days are longer, nights are shorter. Sometimes the days are shorter and nights are longer. They are not equal. This is happening just because of the Earth's inclined axis and its revolution around the Sun. That day, if you have seen that video, you can see the inclined axis or the axis of rotation of the Earth is little cross. And because of that, the days and the nights are not equal over here every time. In Northern Hemisphere, now which is the Northern Hemisphere? If you have observed this figure here present, which was there on the first diagram. Yes. The middle line you can see of that globe is called as equator. The upper part which is present near the North Pole, from that equator, the half circle is upper part is called as Northern Hemisphere, and the downward part is called as the Southern Hemisphere. So we'll just go further now. I've just shown you so that it will be more clear to you. Okay. In Northern Hemisphere, between 22nd March and 23rd September, the days are longer and nights are shorter. What I have told you, in Northern Hemisphere, the upper part, between 22 March and 23 September, the days are longer than the nights, means days are longer and nights are shorter. So it is warmer there. That's why you can see a summer season, whichever is present, it is present in these only months. So we have almost faced our summer season, and right now the rainy is going on. That is why the summer in the Northern Sphere. However, during this same period in Southern Hemisphere, the nights are longer than the days. If Northern Hemisphere, means upper side, the days are longer and night are shorter, what will be at the Southern Hemisphere? Yes, in Southern Hemisphere, the days will be shorter and nights will be longer. So after 23 September, in Southern Hemisphere, the days will be longer and nights will be shorter. And in Northern Hemisphere, the days will be shorter and night will be longer. So now in Southern Hemisphere, what will go on? Yes, there will be summer season, and at our place, we will be having winter season. Okay? So, in the period from 23rd September to 22nd March, the days are longer than the night in the Southern Hemisphere. It gets more heat and it is summer there. Just now I have told you same thing. The Northern Hemisphere gets less heat, and that is why it is winter. We are present in the Northern Hemisphere. That is why nowadays you can see, or just 1 month before, we were having our summers. And we are present in Northern Hemisphere, and that is the main reason that we are having the days are longer over here and nights are shorter. But as soon as 23 September will get over, thus we will be facing winter season, and at our side, the days will be shorter and nights will be longer. Okay? So this part, just clear it out. Note that there may be differences in these days also due to leap year. It is not fixed. There might be changes because of the leap year. 2020, this is a leap year. So there might be changes in these days. Might be one day will increase, one day might be decreased over here. Now, in India, summer, the rainy and the winter are considered as main season. In our India, we are knowing main three season. The summer, which is called as Unara, winter, which is called as Hivara, and rainy, which is called as Pausara. So these three main seasons are considered in India. So we also divide a year. In India, the summer, the rainy and winter are three main seasons. We can divide these three seasons into equally two parts. So if you divide that three main seasons, one season into two parts, you can see there will be six seasons later. So which are that six seasons? Yes, in Marathi we am going to tell them. It is Vasant, Grishma, Varsha, Sharad, Hemant and Shishir. When we divide this year into six seasons, it is called as Vasant, Grishma, Varsha, Sharad, Hemant and Shishir. So this cycle of six season is called as Ritu Chakra. What is this cycle of six season called as? Yes, this six season cycle is called as Ritu Chakra. So if the question is asked to you, what is Ritu Chakra? You are supposed to answer, the year is divided into six season, that is Vasant, Hemant, Grishma, Sharad, Varsha and Shishir. This cycle of six season is called as Ritu Chakra. Many of our festivals are connected with these seasons. Many of our songs and games are also related to different seasons. For example, now we know that Ganpati festival or Ganesh Chaturthi, it has been celebrated in the month of August, September. So in these months, you can tell one thing that we cannot say that in summer season, this time the Ganpati festival, the Ganesh Chaturthi will be held. You cannot decide it. So these festivals like Diwali also, it is based on that particular seasons. Okay, so we will go further. That are phases of moon. Phases means what? You can see that moon is not equal every day. You can see the shape, the size of the moon changing. Sometimes it is decreasing, sometimes it increase. So what actually this is? Yes, these are phases of moon. We will study in more detail here. The full moon and the new moon. Full moon means Purnima and new moon means Amavasya. Again, I am telling, full moon means Purnima and new moon means Amavasya. So we will just go further. The moon revolves around the earth and the earth revolves around the sun. Along whom the moon is revolving? Yes, moon is revolving around the earth. And along whom the earth is revolving? Yes, earth is revolving around the sun. Moon prithvi bhavati firto hai and prithvi hi surya bhavati firte. However, these two orbits intersect. So what is the meaning of orbit? If you have heard the first lesson or if you have seen the first lesson video, you will be knowing this answer. So what is mean by orbit? Yes, the path along which the planets revolve around the sun, it is called as orbit. Path means what? On the way which these planets go, a certain path is been given to them. So that path is called as orbit. So when they are going like this, when they are revolving, their orbits intersect. When earth is revolving around the sun and the moon is revolving around the earth, their orbits intersect. Intersect means meet. Hence the sun, moon and the earth are not always in a straight line. You cannot say if they are intersecting, but they are sometimes, rarely they are coming in a straight line. Rarely means very few times. We can see half of the moon's surface which faces the earth. We cannot see the full side of it, we can only see the half side of the moon. That is why from the earth we can only see one side of the moon. Why we can see only one side of the moon? Yes, because the earth's orbit and moon's orbit intersect each other. we can only see the part of the moon which is facing near the earth. Okay, the moon has no light of its own. We are knowing this. Moon is having no light. It is just the reflection of sunlight. Or we can see that light because of the sunlight which falls on it. On a full moon night, means on Purnima, we see the entire side of the moon that faces the earth. When there is a Purnima, you can see there is a full moon present in the sky. But on the new moon night, means Amavasya, we cannot see any part of it. Why? Because it is not visible from the earth side. From the full moon to the new moon, you can see Purnima till Amavasya, you can see that the moon is changing its size and it is getting decreased. Okay? So these different shapes of the moon are called as phases of moon. The different shapes of the moon are called as phases of the moon. So over here now, what is meant by lunar month and tithi? They have asked you about lunar month and tithi also. So one thing you remember, from one, for example, just now 2 days before only you have seen there was Amavasya. So from one Amavasya to the next Amavasya, there is the period of 28 to 30 days. Eka Amavasya pasna dusre Amavasya paryanta 28 days are required to complete it. So these 28 days or 30 days which are present from one Amavasya to the another Amavasya, or one new moon to another new moon, or one full moon to another full moon, one Purnima to another Purnima, that 28 days which are required are, that is called as lunar month. I'm just telling you the shortest of part of it. What I have told, the period from one new moon to the next new moon is 28 to 30 days, and that is called as lunar month. And every day of lunar month is called as a tithi. So what is tithi? Yes, every day of lunar month is called as tithi. So here they have given you two new words, that is the waxing moon and the waning moon. What is waxing moon? You know that it takes 14 or 15 days from new moon to full moon. New moon means what? Amavasya. Full moon means what? Purnima. Amavasya to Purnima, there are 15 days required. So that is called as waxing moon. And from full moon to new moon again 14 to 15 days are required. So if you see, eka Purnime pasun dusrya Purnime paryanta, from one full moon to another full moon, there are 28 to 30 days required, and that is called as lunar month. And every day of lunar month is called as a tithi. Okay, now you can see in this diagram here, clearly they have shown you the phases of moon. Yes, I'll just show you the one down over here. Yes, yeah, very good. Yes, so this is called as the full moon. Later you can see how it is getting decreased. The upper side in this figure, you can see it is little darker now. After few days you can see it is totally dark. Later the half part of that is totally disappeared. Again you can observe here, it is just going on decreasing. Yes, and you can see later here, it is just in a curved shape, and finally you can see a small edge like this, and one day there is nothing in the sky. So that is called as Amavasya, and this is called as Purnima. Okay, fine. The next part of this lesson will be explained to you later. I hope you have understood this. Just go through your textbook as well as this video when you are going to listen. I'll give few questions. Hopefully, please solve them. Thank you.